وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
In your videos on the Muslim family, you mentioned a series of books. Can you please recommend a book for bringing up children? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala abdillahi wa rasulih nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So as someone who primarily takes their Islamic knowledge and Islamic reading from Arabic sources, I do sometimes find it difficult to recommend English books or to stay up to date with all of the English books that are available. I did have a good look through a number of different publishers and resources as to where you might find some of the books that I had referenced in Arabic in English. But I would still say that the best books that I know of in the English language are a series of four books by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Jibali. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect and preserve him. These are The Quest for Love and Mercy, which deals with looking for a spouse; Closer Than a Garment, which deals with intimacy in marriage; The Fragile Vessels, which deals with the rights of husband and wife; and a book called Our Precious Sprouts, which deals with raising children. And that book, Our Precious Sprouts, would be my first port of call in the English language for a book on the topic of children and raising children. I would also recommend, for sure, if you can find excerpts translated from the amazing book Tuhfatul Mawdud by Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala. And even also, there are some excerpts also on this topic from Zad al-Ma'ad. But Tuhfatul Mawdud is a book by Ibn Qayyim on the topic of the raising of children or the rulings related to newborn children. And towards the end of the book, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala discusses matters related to older children as well. And I have, when I searched online, just searching Tuhfatul Mawdud, you can find translations, excerpts, paragraphs, articles that have been translated on particular topics. So that would be something very beneficial. And you can also find translations of some of the works of Ibn al-Jawzi, rahimahullah ta'ala, on this topic. There is a book called Sincere Counsel to the Seekers of Sacred Knowledge. And this book also contains some very beneficial points in that regard. And there are also some smaller books in English. There's a book on family life by Sheikh Suleiman Raheli, hafidhahullah ta'ala. There is an explanation of the book of marriage from Bulugh al-Maram by Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala. And there are other sort of smaller books and little things by various scholars of the modern era. But I would say that those four books in English by Sheikh Muhammad al-Jibali, definitely for me, it's a must-have in terms of English relating to marriage, the family, and children. Definitely in Arabic, the resources are huge and there are many, many references that a person can use, no doubt about that. But I would say in terms of what's available and appears to have been translated, do have a look for works by Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala on the topic, and also Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah ta'ala, as both of those have been translated and they were among the resources that I would have referred to during the course, inshallah ta'ala, and Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.